Hi, I'm Grant Golden, and I'm here today at the beautiful Bees for Book exhibition on the second floor of the Downtown Library in Buffalo. Today we're going to be reading a few poems and a short story by a famous English authoress, Beatrix Potter. I'll begin with the little poems. I know it looks like a great big volume of poetry, but I assure you, it's not very many poems in there. Here we go, Apply Dapply's Nursery Rhymes. Apply Dapply's Nursery Rhymes by Beatrix Potter. Apply Dapply, a little brown mouse, goes to the cupboard in somebody's house. In somebody's cupboard, there's everything nice. Cake, cheese, jam, biscuits, all charming for mice. Apply Dapply has little sharp eyes, and Apply Dapply is so fond of pies. Now who is this knocking? Now who is this knocking at Cottontail's door? Tap, tap it, tap, tap it. She's heard it before. And when she peeps out, there is nobody there but a present of carrots put down on the stair. Hark, I hear it again. Tap, tap, tap it, tap, tap it. Why, I really believe it's a little black rabbit. Old Mr. Pricklepin. Old Mr. Pricklepin has never a cushion to stick his pins in. His nose is black and his beard is gray, and he lives in an ash stump over the way. You know the old woman? You know the old woman who lived in a shoe, who had so many children she didn't know what to do? I think if she lived in a little shoe house, that little old woman was surely a mouse. Diggory Delvet. Diggory, Diggory Delvet. A little old man in black velvet, he digs and he delves. You can see for yourselves the mounds dug by Diggory Delvet. Gravy and potatoes. Gravy and potatoes in a good brown pot. Put them in the oven and serve them very hot. There once was a guinea pig. There once was an amiable guinea pig who brushed back his hair like a periwig. He wore a sweet tie as blue as the sky, and his whiskers and buttons were very big. Anybody know who this is? This is our friend Peter Rabbit, and I'm going to tell his story next. The Tale of Peter Rabbit by Beatrix Potter. Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits, and their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They live with their mother in a sandbank underneath the root of a very big fir tree. "Now, my dears," said Mrs. Rabbit one evening, "you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go to Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor. Now run along and don't get into mischief. I am going out." Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went out through the woods to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and five currant buns. Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. But Peter, who I'm sad to report was very naughty, went straightway to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. Well, first he ate some lettuces and some French beans, and then he ate some radishes. And then, feeling rather sick, he went on to look for some parsley. But round the end of a cucumber frame, who should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting out young cabbages, but he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving his rake and shouting, "Stop! Stop, thief!" Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten the way back to the gate. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other one amongst the potatoes. Well, after losing them, he ran on all fours and went faster, so that I think he might have gotten away altogether if he had not unfortunately run into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his jacket. It was a blue jacket with brass buttons. quite new. Peter gave himself up for lost and shed big tears, but his sobs were overheard by some friendly sparrows who flew to him in great excitement and implored him to exert himself. "Come on, Peter, you can do it." Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop upon the top of Peter, but Peter wriggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind him. He rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under each. Presently, Peter sneezed. Mr. McGregor was after him in no time, and he tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of a window, upsetting three plants. The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter. He went back to his work. Peter sat down to rest, and he was out of breath and trembling with fright, and had not the least idea which way to go. Also, he was very damp with sitting in that can. After a time, he began to wander about, going lippity, lippity, not very fast, and looking all round. He found a door in a wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out of the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her for the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. She only shook her head at him. Peter began to cry. Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became more and more puzzled. Presently, he came to a pond where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish. She sat very, very still, but now and then the tip of her tail twitched as if it were alive. Peter thought it best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard all about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin Bunny. He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Scratch, 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 scratch. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but presently, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed upon the wheelbarrow and peeped over. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned toward Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Peter got down very quietly off the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could go along the straight walk behind some black currant bushes. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner, but Peter didn't care. He slipped underneath the gate and was safe at last in the wood outside the garden. Mr. McGregor hung up the little jacket and the shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him till he got home to the big fir tree. He was so tired that he flopped right down onto the nice soft sand in the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. His mother was busy cooking. She wondered what he had done with all of his clothes. This was the second little jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in a fortnight. That's 2 weeks, boys and girls. I'm sorry to say, Peter was not very well during the evening. His mother put him to bed and made some chamomile tea, and she gave a big dose of it to Peter. One tablespoonful to be taken at bedtime. But Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. The end. Thank you all for joining me today for these poems and short story by Beatrix Potter. We'll see you again with something new someday.